Thank you for bearing with us. Something crazy must have happened, but if it was crazy, I definitely think I deserve more than one pack. Alright guys, it's time to talk about the elephant in the room, and I just wanted to bring some light to, or just kind of talk about a card that's just been doing a little bit too much right now. Before we get into the discussion, if you are new or a regular, make sure you hit that subscribe button. It would help me out a lot. A lot of people that watch my videos forget to hit that subscribe button, so it would help me out a lot if you guys did that. I really wanted to just do a quick video on this card, and then I'll get into some gameplay, show you guys a nice cool Haven deck that I've been working on. It's an old deck, but it actually works way better than I think most people would give credit for. This card right here is enabling too much in the game right now, in my opinion. I think it's a little bit just a little bit too strong. The ability to lower cards, mocking our natural cards by 3, I feel like that's what's killing the game. Like, they nerfed Damien and they nerfed Shiftsbane so quickly, and as just because they were like the finishers, right? They were finishing the game. That was the card or the effect that was finishing the game. But I feel like they left this card kind of like in the midst of things, and it's too strong, and it's powering up some of the bigger decks a little bit too hard. And I like blood, but it's too strong what it does to mono. So what I wanted to do is just to go through, nonchalant like, and just show every card that it just makes stupid. So even at the 3 cost, right? When Natural Almachinus's effect goes through, right? These are just some of the natural cards I have it that you can kind of much see in all of them. It just, look how strong this is, right? So for Haven, I get this card for free. This is only 3. I should actually just do 3 and below just for as an example, right? 3 and below. So these cards would actually be usable free. Now, not every deck obviously can utilize the thing that well. And this is just the cards that come out for free. It is obviously Valdane. If you use Valdane, he goes down to 1 cost, which is crazy. We'll look at the 4 costs as well too. Not these cards aren't really that crazy. Nothing too nuts about this as far as this. I mean, nothing too crazy about most of the 2-drops. I don't think the 2-drops go anything crazy. Like, yeah, you get this for free, not that big of a deal. For storm purposes, Squeaky is actually kind of crazy because you can play him for 0, run him into something, and kind of like play some trees. Not that bad of a thing. This card is absolute cancer bait when he's reduced to 0, and then that's like 2 free trees. You play him for 0, 2 free trees, and for the Valdane aspect of it, it's nuts. This one's, it's okay. It's okay. This is free, which is actually really good for, but see, Natra, the fusion, I'm speaking about like the slight fusion decks, right? So you're not gonna really run a fusion on Rune, right? You might actually run it in Sword. This card will go down to being a 4-drop, which is pretty crazy because it gives you back, how much points? It gives you back 6 points. So you could actually use some really crazy combos with that. This card becomes a 0-drop, which is insane. There's a lot of crazy stuff that this Fox Lancer can enable if you run the mixture. Cradle's okay. Cradle goes down to a 4-drop, which is really good for that deck. And Blood is one of the ones that can easily run the double. They can easily run the double trait. Now, I feel like the Machina cards are pretty much like more or less where the craziness comes into. Like, even if now you look at Forest, right? Forest in their power deck, if you were running double, you could get this. This is a 0-cost Storm. 3-3 Storm. We already know mono is pretty much one of the reasons why this video is being made. Robo Whip is actually pretty strong too. I've seen the circulation of Havencraft Machina Fusion. It's the Machina Fusion. I say Machina Fusion because it's more geared towards having the Machina cards and healing, and you throw in a couple of the natural cards in there, and then you get this as a 0-drop, and you, it's kind of sick. I actually really like it. I hope people see it. Hope more people play it because it's actually pretty strong. This as a 0-cost bounce is kind of hilarious. Kind of hilarious, and it's a draw engine in that deck. Same thing with Cleft, and that's why they nerfed that the Iron Glade person, right? Because it was so crazy how much he was reducing cards in the Machina Forest deck, but they could still technically enable that with the Natural Machina. So it's not like they took complete care of it. You could still kind of have it, right? You could still kind of have that happen. It's just a little bit later, and it's through 1 card, and it's still RNG based, but it's still able to happen, which I think, you know, that was the weird thing. This card, oh my god, I've seen this played for 0 a couple times, and it's not good. This card is a 0 is nuts. This card is 0 is nuts. Yeah, Damien, I think before he was a 6-drop, so if you, other times he was actually coming out as a 3-drop, right? If he got from Natural Machina to 3-drop, now he comes out as a 4-drop, but it's not that bad. It's still pretty good. And anything else that comes out, like, that's why it's kind of weird that people are like, you don't see Forest Machina that often anymore, but I feel like it's just as strong. You just have to throw in a couple like natural cards in there, like, you know, like, you obviously this card itself and the Changeling Cherub, I think it's called. Yeah, that one too. It's nothing. You could definitely get two, definitely fuse one of them, and then every other card that comes out from the Machina is gonna benefit from it. So it's a little bit crazy. Sanguine Cores is really good. it's really, really good, because you can play it for zero and then have something else evolve, which Blood has a lot of free evolves. So speaking of which, free evolve, and Nuon is a free evolve, and you can heal yourself 10. It's Blood benefits, I think, the most from it. So I guess they would be the one that's hindered from it. And they don't even need it. Honestly, they don't. And Portal, I've seen it once or twice, the Portal fusion, like you fuse both of them. And some of these cards also, World Reaver comes out and he's brought down. It's a little quirky. Now we're into four drops. This thing goes down to one cost. Ugh, disgusting. Even if you were to run it, I definitely think you can do Natra, Machina, Runecraft. I think it's possible this would be a one drop. It just throws off, and everyone that I've known that ever played this game is always saying, like, you know, it's kind of crazy when you reduce the cost of stuff. That's why Runecraft spell boost has always been a hassle, because once, you know, that starts to tick, you don't really know what's going on. And that's the same thing. Once a Blood player plays Natural Machinist, I assume that I'm lost. I feel like he has at least one mono that's zero cost. Look at this. This becomes a three drop. Ooh, I mean, sorry, it becomes a one drop. Kind of crazy. This card's actually pretty good too. You don't see it ran because before it was super aggro, but I feel like you might see it come back if people want to play Forest Machina, because it's not that bad. Even this as a one drop is kind of nuts, especially when you Evo it and then start attacking and lowering every other card cost. You don't see it that often, Portal Machina, because the artifact version I think is better, a little bit more sustainable, but I think you might see a resurgence of it pretty soon. As you guys know, Baldane. And my friend, he's been playing, I don't have all the cards for it, but Swordcraft Natra is ridiculous right now. And I feel like if you mix just a little couple Machina cards, even if it's just the core and the Changeling Cherub, you could possibly get this for one and then some of the other cards for one cost. Also, all the King's Mites are actually a natural spell too. So you could do a really cool fusion with those two cards. I think Baleon, even if you do a Machina heavy, would even still be good, because there's a lot of cards, especially the Aether, that will give you back play points. So I think it would be really crazy to see that work. Not too much in the 5-drop. This card is not that bad. It becomes a 2-drop. And when you draw me, it does some cool stuff, helps you trade like crazy. It's not that bad. It's okay. But then, boom, this is one of the better cards, honestly, in the fusion deck, right? Because you have the Machina package with a little bit of Natura in there. And then when you have Elena's Prayer out, or if you have the Robo guy that we just talked about, you can actually fuse one card at a time, because you only do one fusion at a time per turn. And then, boom, that's one heal. That's AoE healing across the board. Not healing, but they get +1/+1, right? Across the board. So, and this card is a 2-cost storm that if you've been fusing it has drained, so you can get all your health back that you sacrificed to kind of set up your stuff and ward and bank. Yeah, stop it. Card is dumb when it's reduced. Like, it's cool. It enables really cool play, right? So you don't want to like completely nerf bat it, right? But they need to change it. And I would curious of what you guys would want as a change, right? Like, how would you want to change the card? I was trying to do a Lytica deck, like Forest Fairy deck and stuff like that, and then fuse it with Machina. I couldn't figure it out, but I would love to drop this as a 2-drop, right? A 2-drop that evolves 6/6 for free, because a tree should be out there on that deck. Oh, that'd be nuts. And I think this is like the Runecraft Natra, right? Like, you play it in a certain way where you get Riley slowly but surely instead of rushing to get her, and maybe you have this in there with the Machina, something like that, who knows. I did it once where I did it with Lubelle, and it's nice, you have a 2-cost Lubelle. And the amount of trades that come out of that, it's mostly a Toph deck, it's more Natra focused than Machina. But I've been trying. Nothing too crazy here on the natural side of 6-drops. Viridian Magna, obviously pretty good. A 3-drop that, for what it does, would be nuts. Very easy to trade into. Chitsbane, obviously 3-cost that it evolves for free. And when 10 play points, it's kind of nuts. Same thing with Mistalina, kind of nuts. Because she pretty much gives herself Storm, and she can easily afford every other follow-up after that. All the 6-drops here are not really played except Vice currently in the meta. Aranea is not that bad. She's a 6-cost, and I'll show you guys. If you guys want, I have a shadow deck too that is kind of utilizing it. It is a fusion deck. It's not that bad. It's okay. But yeah, you can get her for three costs. Not that bad. No one plays Slain anymore, but would be pretty stupid. But right now, I feel like the deck kind of just don't need him. He's too cluttery if he comes out. There's so much better options. Just flood the board like a madman. This card you don't see at all, really. Don't see this at all, but could be good in some way, shape, or form, I guess. And since I messed up with the filter, we already seen 7 because I had it on by accident. This one is nice. You get a 5-cost 8/8 storm. Yeah, that sounds up the money right there. And it's 5-cost, so you can even like throw some other cards in there. I'd be interested to see that 5-cost Dead Knot Gorilla. Now, interesting with the He Who Rocks, right? So you can get him down to 7 if you never played him at all, right? But if you actually played his thing, you can get him as a 9-drop, which then brings him down to 6. And He Who Once Rocked is actually a really good card once you learn how to pilot him a little bit better, which I didn't at the time. So I didn't pilot him that good. Same thing with here, we got the World Reader that goes down to a 5-drop, which is absolutely insane. And Techno Lord in the Natura deck that I have, in the Natura Machina deck that I have for Shadow, is actually really good. Because with for Shadow, I can actually play him for 5, Techno Lord for 5, and if He Who Once Rod died at any point in time, he actually will give me back him. And it's a really crazy like situations that you can put your opponent in. So that was just kind of the basis of the card. So let me know, you guys think I'm overreacting? Do I think that the card can be balanced in some different ways? Does it need to be balanced? Is it we're calling it too early? What do you guys think? I think that it definitely extras. I need some cards, man. I've been trying to craft so much stuff, man. I need help. This deck that I have here is pretty much the Haven deck that I was talking to you guys about. It runs really good. It runs really, really good. If you guys want, I can put it in the description. It's pretty much the Storm deck that they had before, but it just, like I said, it just runs really good. I really like it. This is my fusion one, right? Natura Haven, it works really good. I don't know how viable it is, but it runs pretty good. Once you learn how to navigate it a little bit, runs really good. So maybe I'll do one or the other, or I'll do this in the next video if you guys wanna see it in action. But we're gonna do the Amulet Haven because I haven't done that yet. And then, if you guys wanna see this, let me know what video do you guys want? With more than one match in it, right? And look, we're going against the demon itself. Really good matchup actually for us. Because I highly doubt he can deal with the pressure. Not that bad of a curve. We are playing second, so keeping this is not that bad of a thing. Keeping this is kind of a bad thing. I'm going to bounce it. I want to get some of my earlier cards. I even will bounce this too. Okay, but not the best thing. We do draw second, so we could draw into something. I'm hoping for something I could play a little bit earlier. Hey, thank you. Alright, so this is turn one, right? Turn two is definitely Squeaks. We want to put a minion out and then start attacking them. Pilgrims is kind of better to just play it on your fifth turn. I do have a Hallowed Dogma, though. This thing doesn't give you, it doesn't give you one. So if you play this early and you don't have a way to, like, lower it, it's kind of stupid. This is definitely going to be a turn three. So now, I got a minion out, you son of a... Ooh, thank you, Poppy. Alright. Going second on this deck is really good because I can literally Evo this. If I were to play it like delay the turn and I play it on turn 4, that's 4 damage to his face. I don't know if he's going self-ping or if he's going, as we've been stating, he's going a fusion. And I've seen them lately go with, they put this card in there. I think that sometimes they don't even play the tree, they just keep it in there. It's pretty much a 2-drop that puts a card in their hand that they can use for fusion. So it allows you not to like be naked all day. But I think this deck, I think what we might be fighting, it might not be Machina. No, he played it. So he's either doing a fusion deck or he's going like a strong face damage nonsense. Ooh, we got this. Ooh. That's kind of hard to give up. Because I can actually activate it next turn. Nothing else that I have really needs to be played at the moment. This card is just too strong. He might be going face, but we are too. If he leaves this up, we can Evo it. We can also Evo this, because we can Hallowed it. Turn 4, we can play a tree, Hallow it. Or Hallow it first to see what we get, and then Evo it, and it's really pesky for him to try to deal with it. I fought this deck before, yeah. He's actually aggro too. He's actually aggro too. Can he out-aggro me? Oh, I could, this is even a better line of play. I get to keep my Hallowed. I play a natural tree and this card actually lowers, he gets stronger. Such a good card. Such a good card.
I've come to lead you out of the dark.
Boom.
Heaven may abandon me, but I will not.
So we're gonna Evo this because he has to stop his aggro and immediately and deal with it.
Power is for everyone.
So he has to do some weird shit like that. I'm gonna make it even worse for you. I'm actually gonna trade. I need the board space anyway, but I'll make it that he has to do something even weirder. So he'd have to hit it with three and then kill it at one, which I think that I don't know if his deck really can do that safely anyway. Or he leaves it up. Oh, I have four. I have four stuff, right? Four cards in play. Yeah. So he can Evo it. If he insta-kills it, then he just comes back and then he trades it. Which isn't that bad. That's a pretty good. That's pretty good.
People will be lost, but I will.
At the end of the tunnel, there's only darkness.
Okay.
The people will
but
be lost.
I didn't really... sorry, I didn't really gain too much from that. So we're gonna do this. Gives us a lot of thing. We're gonna crash that into the 3-1. Evo this. I do like this deck. It's a different blood deck. Wait, did I just give him vengeance for free? Uh-oh. Forgot who we were fighting. This deck definitely has synergy with vengeance, I'm pretty sure. So Union Burst because he's going... I'm just gonna stop talking. Alright, so this card is not that bad. We have more cards in hand, which I think is gonna be difficult. It goes to Iona. That trades into that, right? Full trade. Feels back a little bit. Now we're on the offensive. But we do have this. And do that. We heal. And I feel like I don't want to bring him into vengeance again. He can do that himself. Next turn we have Daffodilides. Pretty good. And then that's gonna lower our Agnes. Help us out a bit. These cards are really good too. He has more cards in his hand, so I can't really use it that much anymore. But it's still a countdown three and you can swarm him out of nowhere with a bunch of 2/4s. He is another card that would get affected if I was running the mixture, right? He'd be a one drop. One drop, 2/4 storm, which isn't that crazy of stats, honestly.
You must become a demon to kill a demon.
This deck is cool. It feels it's just aggro, right? It just feels like he's aggro me, so we're going aggro for aggro.
Crawl back into the darkness.
That hurts.
Ooh, this card's really good. Can definitely do some trades with that. All right, so we're definitely gonna hit this. Evo hit this. I feel like I need the trade though, honestly.
What an eyesore! Ah, close is my tail. Follow my lead.
Definitely doing that.
Eradicate all demons.
All right, we'll probably trade into... Kill that. And then do one more. So that lets me evil over that, keep the ward. And then play this and trade. If he has Nerea, which he should, I'm pretty sure that there's no way you don't run Nerea in that deck. He may be, oh, is he searching for it? Does he not have it? That would suck. Oh yeah, there we go. That card is the stopper of all things. Well, Blood always got tricks up the sleeve, I guess, huh? Not much I can do about this. These cards are very pesky and annoying for my deck. Ugh. Ooh, interesting. I can Elo it for free, but it doesn't really... It does trade into that, right? No, it really doesn't. It actually does not trade into that. And once I attack with it, this thing's gonna die. Because it doesn't have enough stats. This thing doesn't trade into it either. This card is so strong. It's so strong. Yo, if that thing was Natural Machina, I would actually be crying. Yeah, there's nothing I think that was doable there. That's just too much pressure that he put on the board and I didn't have Evos. I know I could actually clear this. I could have cleared the 4-4, but I had 5 health. All in all, this deck is good, I promise you. I hope you saw a little bit of how fast it can be and how good it can be. But events another aggro deck, I guess maybe we don't stand the test of time. But actually, I'm not really used to playing that deck either. All I know is that Nerea is good, so any deck that... It allows Nerea to come out and do what she does for free is pretty damn strong. I'll have to say that. But I'll put this deck in the description. I think it's good enough that if you guys wanted to try it out, I wouldn't craft for it. If you have the cards already, feel free. But I wouldn't craft it. It's not that strong in the current meta. Anywho, let me know what deck you guys want to see. This deck, again, more matches of it to shoot so I can prove what I'm talking about. Or you guys want to see that new Shadow deck because tournament winning decks. Oh, Forest did some stuff. Ooh, Sword. Okay. Okay, Rune. Got some options. Dragon. Okay. Artifact. Okay. Machina Elena. Even Blood. What? No respect for Shadow right now in this expansion. So, let me know what you guys want. And just remember that every day at the casino is your lucky day. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.